In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software, Infinite Algebra 1, free worksheet, solving rational equations, part 2, or solving rational equations hard. Now our instructions are to solve each equation and to remember to check for extraneous solutions. So let's get started with number 1. In number 1, remember when adding or subtracting rationals, we need to have a common denominator. And k plus 4 over 4 has the same denominator as k minus 1 over 4. So we can go ahead and add those at the start. So k plus 4 plus k minus 1 over 4 is equal to k plus 4 over 4k. So my next step, I'm going to combine k with k in my numerator on my left-hand side, and I'm going to combine 4 and 1. So k plus k is 2k, and 4 minus 1 will be plus a positive 3, and that's all over 4. Now that is equal to k plus 4 over 4k. And remember, we're trying to solve, and by solving, we're solving for what that variable k is equal to. So my next step in this problem, I'm going to multiply both sides by 4k. By doing that, my 4k will cancel out in my denominator on the right because 4k divided by 4k is 1. But note on the left that my 4 in the denominator will cancel out with the 4 that's multiplied to the k. So I'll just have on my left-hand side k times 2k plus 3 equivalent to k plus 4. So now I'll distribute this k, multiplying it to 2k and multiplying it to 3. So k times 2k is 2k squared plus k times 3 is 3k, and that's going to be equal to k plus 4. Now I'm going to subtract k from both sides in order to cancel the k out on my right-hand side, and I'm going to subtract 4 in order to cancel the 4 out. So I'm going to have a quadratic equal to 0. So 2k squared plus 3k minus 1k is 2k, and then we're subtracting 4 from that, and that is all equivalent to 0. Now 2, 2, and 4 are all divisible by 2, so I'll pull a 2 out from that quadratic. So within my parentheses, I'll have k squared plus k minus 2, and that's going to be equal to 0. Now I'm going to factor the quadratic within my parentheses. So I'm going to see what multiplies to give me negative 2 and adds to give me a positive 1. And that's going to be 1 and 2, where the 1 is negative. Negative 1 times 2 is negative 2, and negative 1 plus 2 is a positive 1. So I'll have 2 times k minus 1 times k plus 2, and that's equal to 0. In order for a quantity to equal 0, it needs to be either 0 itself or multiplied by 0. So for 2 times k minus 1 times k plus 2 to equal 0, either k minus 1 equals 0 or k plus 2 equals 0. So let's solve first for when k minus 1 equals 0. All we need to do is add 1 to both sides to get that k is equal to 1. So if k is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, and 0 times any quantity is 0. Now, if k plus 2 is equal to 0, I'll subtract 2 from both sides to get that k is equal to negative 2. So if k was negative 2, negative 2 plus 2 is 0, and 0 times any quantity is 0. Therefore, my solutions, and number 1, writing it as set notation, I'll have negative 2 and 1. Those are my two separate solutions in number 1. K can be negative 2 and k can be 1. So essentially, if k is 1, I'll plug 1 in for k and the equation will hold true. And if k is negative 2, I'll plug negative 2 in for k and that equation will be true. So if you want to double check, feel free to plug in either of those and solve. Now let's continue on to number 2. In number 2, at the start, I'm going to multiply both sides by 2m squared because I want this 2m squared out of the denominator, but when I multiply by 2m squared, I'll also be able to cancel out m and 2 from the other denominators on the other side of my equation. So multiplying 2m squared to 1 over 2m squared and multiplying 2m squared to 1 over m minus 1 over 2, you can see that my 2m squared will cancel out with 2m squared, to leave me with 1 on the left-hand side of my equation, and that's going to be equivalent to 2m squared over m minus 2m squared over 2. And that's by distributing 2m squared to 1 over m and 1 half. Now note that 2 over 2 will equal 1, and m squared over m will equal m to the first. Because my law of exponents, if I have m squared over m to the first, or simply m, that's m to the 2 minus 1, which equals m to the first, or m, and that will be in my numerator. So simplifying, I'll have 1 equal to 2m minus m squared. Now I'll go ahead and make this quadratic equal to 0. And in order to do that, I'll add m squared to both sides, so that my m squared will be positive on the left-hand side. And I'll subtract 2m from both sides, so that I have 0 on my right-hand side. So this will be m squared minus 2m plus 1 equal to 0. Now I'll factor m squared minus 2m plus 1. So I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me 1 and add to give me negative 2. And that will be negative 1 and negative 1. Because negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1, and negative 1 plus negative 1 is negative 2. So rewriting this quadratic, I'll have m minus 1 times m minus 1 equal to 0, which is essentially m minus 1 squared equal to 0, because m minus 1 times m minus 1 is m minus 1 squared, because both of these are to the first. So my last step will be to see when m minus 1 equals 0. When that's equivalent to 0, 0 squared is 0. So m minus 1 equals 0 when, adding 1 to both sides, m is equal to a positive 1. So in set notation, I have 1 as my solution. When m is equal to 1, or in other words, plugging 1 in for m, this equation will be true. And double checking, 1 over 2 times 1 squared is 1 half, and that's equal to 1 minus 1 half, which is 1 half. So I get that 1 half is equivalent to 1 half when I plug 1 in for m, and that is indeed true. So 1 is my solution in number 2. For number 3, I have n minus 6 over n squared, and I'm going to be subtracting 2n plus 12 over n from that quantity, and that will equal n minus 6 over 2n. Now, none of my denominators are the same. However, I'm going to make this fraction have the same denominator as n squared so that I can subtract. And I'll do that by multiplying by 1. And that 1 that I'm going to be multiplying by is n over n. And if you're confused on why I'm multiplying by 1, refer back to a previous video, adding and subtracting rational expressions. On that CUDA software worksheet, we went more in depth as to why we multiply by 1 in order to help us add or subtract. So I'll have n minus 6 over n squared minus, now I'm going to be distributing that n to 2n plus 12. So that will be 2n squared plus 12n over n times n, which is n squared, and that's going to equal n minus 6 over 2n. Now, because I have the same denominator, I can subtract these numerators. So looking at n squared first, n squared minus 2n squared is going to be negative 1n squared, or negative n squared, and then negative n minus 12n will be negative 13n, so subtracting 13n, and then I'm subtracting 6 from that, and there's no other term that I can combine with 6, so I'll just be subtracting 6, and that's all over n squared, which equals n minus 6 over 2n. Now what I want to do next is I want to get this 2n out of the denominator, and I also want to get n squared out of the denominator. And one easy way to do that would be to multiply both sides by 2n squared. Multiplying both sides by 2n squared, you will see that my 2 indeed will cancel out my 2, and 1n will cancel out one of the n's from my n squared, so I'll be multiplying n to n and 6, And then looking on my left-hand side, n squared will cancel out with n squared. So I'll be multiplying 2 to negative n squared, negative 13n, and negative 6. So I could have multiplied by 2n, but then I still would have had to multiply both sides by n. So essentially, I multiply by 2n times n so that I could cancel out that n squared, but so that I could also cancel out that 2 in one step. So 2 times negative n squared is negative 2n squared, and I'll be subtracting 2 times 13n, which is 26n, and then I'll be subtracting 2 times 6, which is 12, and that's going to be equivalent to n times n, which is n squared, minus n times 6, which is 6n. So my next step, I'll subtract n squared from both sides so that I can cancel out that n squared on my right, and I'll add 6n to both sides so that I can cancel out that 6n on my right so that I have a quadratic equal to 0. So negative 2n squared minus n squared is negative 3n squared. And if I'm subtracting 26 and then adding another 6, that will leave me with negative 20n, so subtracting 20n, and then I'll subtract 12 from that, and that will equal 0. Now, in order to factor this quadratic, I need my 3 to be positive because I do not want a negative with n squared. So I'm going to multiply my left-hand side by negative 1 and my right-hand side by negative 1. So I will have 3n squared plus 20n plus 12 equivalent to 0. Now, I cannot simplify 3, 20, and 12, so I'm going to have to factor by grouping. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me A times C, which is 3 times 12, which is 36, but add to give me a positive 20. And that's going to be 2 and 18. 2 times 18 is 36, and 2 plus 18 is 20. So I'll rewrite 20n as 3n squared plus 2n plus 18n plus 12 equal to 20. Now I'll group my first two terms together and my last two terms together, finding the GCF of each. So for 3n squared plus 2n, that greatest common factor is n. So pulling out an n, I'll have 3n plus 2. And then between 18n and 12, my greatest common factor is 6. So pulling out a 6, I'll get 3n plus 2 again. And that is all equal to 0. So because n and 6 are both multiplied by 3n plus 2, I'll group those together. So I'll have n plus 6 multiplied by 3n plus 2, and that's going to be equal to 0. So my next step will be to see when n plus 6 equals 0 and when 3n plus 2 equals 0. So n plus 6 equals 0 when, subtracting 6 from both sides, n is equal to a negative 6. And 3n plus 2 equals 0. If I subtract 2 from both sides, I'll get that 3n equals negative 2, and then dividing by 3, I'll get that n is equal to negative 2 thirds. So my solutions in number 3 are negative 2 thirds and negative 6. When n is equivalent to either of those, my equation in number 3 will be true. Let's continue on to number 4. Now in number 4, I have x squared, 2x squared, and x squared. So in order to cancel out all of those denominators, I'm going to multiply by 2x squared to each side. So multiplying 2x squared to my right and multiplying 2x squared to my left, you will see that I have 2x squared times 3x squared plus 24x plus 48 all over x squared. And then I'm going to be adding that to 2x squared times x minus 6 over 2x squared. And that will be equal to 2x squared over x squared. So essentially what I did, I just distributed the 2x squared to each of these terms, but I didn't do out the work because I'm going to simplify first. So x squared will cancel out with x squared, and then 2x squared will cancel out with 2x squared, and then lastly on my right hand side, x squared will cancel out with x squared. So all I'll do is take this 2 and distribute it to 3x squared, 24x, and 48. So 2 times 3x squared is 6x squared, and I'll be adding that to 2 times 24, which is 48x, and then adding that to 2 times 48, which is 96. And then I'll add x minus 6 to that, and that will equal 2. Because once I simplified canceling out what would divide to give me 1, that's all that's remaining. I have no denominators. So now I'll combine like terms, grouping 48x with x and grouping 96 with 6. At the same time, I'll also subtract 2 from both sides. So I will be grouping together 96, 6, and 2. So I'll have 6x squared plus 48x plus x is 49x plus 96 minus 6 is 90. And then when I take 2 away from 90, I will get 88. So 6x squared plus 49x plus 88 equals 0. Now, unfortunately, 6 does not go into these evenly, nor does 2 or 3, the factors of 6. So I'm going to have to factor by grouping. That means I need to see what two numbers will multiply to give me A times C, which is 6 times 88, which is 528, and add to give me 49. So this is a lot of trial and error on your calculator, but I already figured out the factors that will work, and that's 16 and 33. 16 times 33 is 528, and 16 plus 33 is equal to 49. So when I rewrite 6x squared plus 49x plus 88, I'll write it as 6x squared plus 16x plus 33x, because 16x plus 33x is 49x, and then I'll add 88 to that, and that will be equal to 0. So when I group my first two terms together and my last two terms together, in my first two terms, I'll be able to pull out an x. But not just an x, I'll also be able to pull out a 2. So pulling out 2x, I'll have 3x plus 8 within my parentheses, since 2x times 3x is 6x squared, and 2x times 8 is 16x, and I'll be adding that 2. I can pull out an 11 from 33 and 88. So pulling out an 11, I'll have 3x plus 8 within my parentheses again. And that's all equal to 0. And because 2x and 11 are multiplied by 3x plus 8 and 3x plus 8, those will be written together within parentheses as 2x plus 11, and that's going to be multiplied by 3x plus 8. And that is all equal to 0. So what I'm going to do is see when 2x plus 11 equals 0 and when 3x plus 8 equals 0. So 2x plus 11 equals 0 when, if I subtract 11 from both sides, 2x equals negative 11, and then I divide by 2 to get that x is equal to negative 11 over 2. Also, 3x plus 8 equals 0 when, subtracting 8 from both sides, 3x equals negative 8, so my last step will be to divide by 3 to get that x is equal to negative 8 thirds. So my solution in set notation for number 4 is negative 8 thirds and negative 11 halves. That is my solution in number 4. Negative 8 thirds and negative 11 halves, if I plug either of those in to our original equation, that will hold true, meaning that the values will indeed make the left-hand side equal to the right-hand side. So again, our final solution in this video was negative 8 thirds and negative 11 halves. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish this first page completing numbers 5 through 8. And here's just a friendly reminder before you move on to like, subscribe, and share. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and just let me know that you're finding these videos useful. So go ahead and do that now.